Are you expecting to watch how to georeference digital or scanned maps in ArcGIS like this, so that they will be matched to our study area? If yes, in this video, I share with you how to georeference JPEG map images in ArcGIS. Make sure to watch to the end of this video to achieve a comprehensive understanding. These are the outline of this video. First, we set the layer's coordinate system as the most important part of data preparation in ArcGIS. Then we learn three ways to georeference JPEG map image which is downloaded from Google. We will georeference map image which have no coordinate, have geographic coordinate, and have projected coordinate. I provide the data that is previously searched in Google image with keywords administrative map of Ottawa. Then I modified it with two types of coordinate, geographic coordinate and projected coordinate, to let you practice with different cases. Let's open our ArcMap software. Here, I use ArcGIS version 10.6. Don't worry if you have a different version, because each version has a similar workflow. Next, we open the data. You can track the data added with SHP, it means Shapefile, and the JPEG map image directly to ArcGIS. Click OK when unknown spatial reference appeared. Let me show another way to add our tutorial data. We can add them by clicking Add Data, choose your folder in the Look-in column. Click several data we want to insert by clicking Ctrl button to select several data at once, then click Add. Click OK when unknown spatial reference appeared. If you don't find your folder's name, you can find it by clicking Disconnect to folder, then choose your localities and click OK. Let's back to the tutorial. Wherever you are in every part of the globe, it is flexible in choosing any location for practicing this tutorial. But here, we use Ottawa, Canada as the study location. Location difference only affects what coordinate system we should use. I get this shapefile data from tifa.gis.org website. The first thing we should do is checking the coordinate system of the shapefile of administrative region we have input. Right-click on the data, then click Properties. Click Source tab and we see the geographic coordinate system as GCSWGS1984. Remember the coordinate system and close this layer properties window. Then we set the overall layer's coordinate system by right-clicking the layers and click Properties. Click Coordinate System tab, click Geographic Coordinate Systems. Click Word and choose WGS1984. You can right-click the chosen coordinate and click Add to Favorites to have an efficient workflow in the future. Then we click OK. If you are not familiar with the shape of the study area, we have to search it on Google Image to check its shape. We see there is a bit different shape between inside the ArcGIS and the Google image. This is usually due to the coordinate system in the ArcGIS. We can fix this by changing the coordinate to a projected coordinate system. It's called UTM or Universal Transverse Mercator. Again, if you are not familiar with the study area, we need to search on Google with keywords word Universal Transfer Mercator as UTM coordinate reference. Click this Wikipedia link. Then, we click the word image on the Wikipedia site. A projected coordinate system of UTM divides Earth into northern and southern hemispheres. For Ottawa in Canada, it is located here in grid number 18 and in northern hemisphere. So, we should choose 18N as the projected coordinate system in our ArcGIS. Let's back to the ArcGIS and we right-click on the layers. Then, click Properties. For searching UTM 18N, we click on the projected coordinate systems. Scroll down and choose UTM. Choose WGS1984. Choose Northern Hemisphere and click on WGS1984 UTM Zone 18N. Finally, we click OK. Well done. It teaches us how to set a coordinate system as the most important part of the first stage of data preparation in ArcGIS. We need to understand the suitable geographic or projected coordinate system we need to use. Here, we successfully made the shape of a table similar to the map on the Google image. We are then ready to do the georeferencing tutorial. First, we try once without the coordinate. Let's move the shapefile data of Ottawa administrative region to the top of the layers. Click on its symbol to change it to a better symbol. Choose new color for the fill color and change the outline color. I choose red for the outline color to distinguish it from the other map layers we want to georeference later. Click OK. Let's uncheck first the other map images. We right-click on the Ottawa map without coordinate and click Zoom to Layer. We start to georeference this map. Make sure you have activated the georeferencing tool by right-clicking on the above tab and click or check the georeferencing option. Select Ottawa map without coordinate in the georeferencing tool, then click Add Control Points icon. We're going to create 3 or 4 control points on the map. Zoom into the most visible corner of the map, left-click on that corner, then right-click on the shapefile of administrative region and click Zoom to Layer. Zoom in and click the same corner. Let's make the second control point. Zoom into another corner and left click on that. Again, right click on the shapefile of administrative region and click Zoom to Layer. Zoom in and left click on the same corner. For the last control point, we zoom in again to another corner. Left click on that and left click the corner of the shapefile of administrative region. Zoom in to see the overall view. The overall map image already matched with the shapefile of administrative region. Click on the georeferencing tool and click update georeferencing. In this step, you will safely delete this map image and insert it again. If we see the folder, there are 2 additional files which are automatically created after this georeferencing step. They are XML document and JPEG file. Let me enter the JPEG data to the ArcGIS and we see the map image is matched. I hope you already understand the basic step on georeferencing an image in ArcMap. Let's move to another case for enhancing our understanding. Let's uncheck the previous georeference map, check the Ottawa map with geographic coordinate layer, and choose Ottawa map with geographic coordinate on the georeferencing tool. Right click on its layer and click Zoom to Layer. We will create 4 control points on each corner of the map. Start from the top left of the map. We zoom in until the X and Y coordinates are shown. Then, left click on the intersection between the X and Y, which is symbolized with a plus sign. Right click on the same place and click Input DMS of long and length. Let's input the longitude first and the latitude. Please make sure they are the same with the displayed longitude and latitude on the map. Also, choose the suitable east or west or north or south option. Finally, click OK. Right click on its layer, then click Zoom to Layer again. Let's zoom into another corner. I choose the top right corner like the previous step we left click. And then right click on the same place and click Input DMS of long and length. Enter the longitude and latitude, then click OK. It's easy, isn't it? With the same pattern, we right-click on its layer and click Zoom to Layer. Zoom into the bottom right corner. Left-click the intersection between longitude and latitude. Right-click on the same place and click Input DMS of long and length. Type the coordinate and click OK. For the fourth time, right-click the layer and choose Zoom to Layer. Now, zoom into the bottom left corner. Left-click, right-click, and select Input DMS of Long and Length. Input the coordinate again, and click OK. Right-click on the layer and click Zoom to Layer to see the overall view. Yes, we did it together for the second case. Don't forget to click the Georeferencing tool and click Update Georeferencing to save the control points. Next, we uncheck this layer and check the entire map with projected coordinates. Use the same map on the Georeferencing tool to activate the georeferencing process on this layer. Right-click on the layer and click Zoom to Layer. Let's do a similar pattern as before. Zoom into the top left corner until the X and Y coordinates are shown. Make sure you still activate this Add Control Points function. Then, left-click on the intersection between X and Y coordinate. Right-click directly on it and choose Input X and Y. Type the X and Y coordinates and click OK. See, it's just a bit different compared with the previous case. Here we go again. Right-click on the layer and click Zoom to Layer. Zoom into the top right corner. Left-click the plus sign, right-click on the same location, and click Input X and Y. Type the X and Y coordinates and click OK. It's the same process. Let's do right-click on the layer, zoom to layer, zoom into another corner. Left-click, right-click, click Input X and Y, type the coordinates. Click OK. So simple. Finally, for the last one, right-click on the layer, zoom to layer, zoom into the last corner. Left-click on the intersection, right-click and choose Input X and Y. Type the coordinates and click OK. To save it, click Georeferencing tool and click Update Georeferencing. Let's compare between the georeference map image without coordinate, with geographic coordinate, and with projected coordinate. As a bonus in the end, it's optional to save the georeference map image into TIFF format. We can do this by right-clicking the georeference map image, choose Data, and click Export Data. Use our folder location. And click Add. Here we are experimenting on how if we set the node data as 0 and then how if we set it as 256. Let's try to set it as 0. Rename our output file and make sure the format is already TIFF. Click Save. Click Yes if we want to directly see the TIFF output file. The dark color of the map image turned into white because we set the node data option as 0. Let's do another trial. Right-click the georeference map image, choose Data, and click Export Data. Here, the output folder location is still the same as the previous location we have chosen. Rename the output file name. Set the node data as 256 as default option. Click Save and click Yes to apply the node data value as 256. If we click No, its result will be the same as we set the node data as 0. Click Yes to show the exported TIFF data. Here, we compare the exported TIFF data with node data as 0 and node data as 256. The node data as 256 is better than the node data as 0. Right-click on the previously exported TIFF data with node data as 0 and click Remove to delete it because we don't need it. Remove the map image layer below the Ottawa administrative layer to show the city boundary layer on the top of any layer. Finally, we did it. To summarize it, all we need to do in georeferencing map image are set the suitable coordinate, insert data, add control points, and update georeferencing. It's optional to save the georeferenced digital maps into TIFF format. The TIFF object data will be accompanied by TFW file, OVR file, and XML document. I'm now working on the next ArcGIS how-to or tutorial video on how to georeference images downloaded from Google Earth. Google Earth is a place where we download free high-quality and high-resolution satellite imagery. If you are waiting for it, you can click the subscribe button and turn the subscription notification on to watch my next how-to or tutorial video immediately. I'll see you very soon.